So, ladies and gentlemen, let me introduce you to the host of tonight's gathering, the founder of the Better Future Association, and my father, Mr. John T. Franklin.
This is all for you.
Yeah, I want you to have the candy, sir.
Thank you. Thank you. Most of you know that I've always felt that what's good for business is good for the community. But my lovely daughter, Elise, has helped me to see that the reverse can also be true. Effective today, I'm announcing the formation of a trust called the Franklin Foundation. With the exception of a very modest living allowance, my entire personal fortune will be used to establish and maintain a network of cutting-edge family crisis centers in every major city in the United States. Families are the bedrock of this country. And right now, there are a lot of...
There he is! Stop him! Elise! Elise! Step back! Step back! We got the shooter! Let go of me! Let go of me! It's a mistake, okay?
People once believed that when someone dies, a crow carries their soul to the land of the dead.
But sometimes something so bad happens that a terrible sadness is carried with it, and the soul can't rest.
Then sometimes, just sometimes, the crow can bring the soul back to put things right.
Things can never be right. My soul will never rest until we are together again.
We all feel that way when we first get here.
What happens now?
Most people go that way.
Is it heaven?
Maybe. Or maybe it's just the next place. They never come back.
Why don't you go?
I'm waiting for someone. For Eric. We were both murdered. He was sent back and I'm here.
I don't think I'm ready to move on yet. Not yet. Can we contact them?
If everything is just right, sometimes I can make Eric feel me or see me. He's even heard my voice. What happened to you?
I was shot to death. After it happened, I could see everything. So odd. Like I wasn't even there anymore. People think my boyfriend did it.
Did he?
We loved each other.
Maybe I can help.
Shelley, I know you're out there somewhere. Talk to me. Touch me. Give me another sign.
Come on, open up. It's like a crud convention out here.
Hey.
You know, I thought maybe you were sleeping, and then I thought, well, you don't sleep. And then I thought, well, what if you finally did sleep, and here I come waking you up.
You don't wait for invitations, do you?
Did some more research on crows and being dead. Check this. According to the Native American folklore, the returned spirit must do more than just gain personal revenge or justice in order to balance the cosmic scales. Yeah, well, you smoked Top Dollar on his puke patrol, and you're still here, right?
Yeah, I'm still here.
He's delayed entrance to the afterlife until his own personal life pluses and minuses are balanced. This can only be achieved by helping others on Earth who are in need.
Wish it were that simple. Just pile up some merit badges. What's that?
It's today's paper. We have to pick a story on current events and describe it to the class.
She's here.
Who's here?
Shelley. I feel her.
You're right. I probably should be getting back for fifth period.
Come on, I told you. I heard the shots. I saw Elise go down. I started to run up to help, and I was dragged down by two Neanderthals. They started yelling I did it, and here I am.
The gun is registered to you. It's got your prints all over it. We got a whole room full of witnesses. Play it smart. Think about the best deal you can make here.
Can I get a glass of water? Or is dehydration part of your standard framing process?
Karen, do you mind?
We're all out of ice. I hope that's okay.
Look, the gun must have been planted, all right? The last time I saw it was at Elise's apartment.
Yeah? You in the habit of taking guns to visit your girlfriend?
I left it with her. I went on a trip about 6 months ago. I left it for her protection.
You and Elise were broken up, isn't that right?
Yeah. Yeah, we took some time apart.
And it had none to do with the fact that her father said publicly he didn't want her to marry you.
Elise has a mind of her own.
How'd you feel about John Franklin? You used to work for him, right?
We had some creative differences on the job. He's certainly not my best friend, but I wouldn't shoot him.
So what were you doing at the announcement?
She called me.
Elise?
She said that she wanted to talk to me afterwards. She sounded different. Resolved. She had some kind of breakthrough in therapy.
What'd she want to talk about?
Well, I was hoping that she wanted to talk about us.
What did she say during the rest of the phone call?
She said that her father had some secrets that would destroy him. So why don't you go investigate him, huh? Check his records, find out if he had an affair or something, because somebody's got something on him. You find out who that is, and you got yourself a killer.
Drink your water.
All I want is justice for my daughter. Now that Hedges isn't going to get off on some loophole, is he?
Well, that's a matter for the attorneys and the courts to decide. But with the help of your statement, we're putting together a very solid case.
Solid? It should be an open and shut case. My security people caught him in the act.
It was pretty amazing timing. You said in the statements you gave at the crime scene that you were already moving to intercept the suspect before he pulled his gun. Was that just luck?
Hardly. One of our people reported someone acting suspicious. When we moved in to investigate, and we saw it was Hedges. I saw him reach. There was a flash of metal. Oh.
Any reason to believe that he would want to harm you?
Well, I fired him from my Seattle operations. You know, Gilbert is a very disturbed young man, and I tried to make Elise see that, but she was blind to it.
Anybody else other than Hedges might hold a grudge against you?
You have your man.
Still, Hedges denies he shot you.
And he indicated that there are other people who might have just as much reason to harm you.
Well, of course he would say that. He's cornered and he's desperate.
We have to check everything, sir.
What is it he said in this statement of his?
Well, unfortunately, it's not information I can disclose since you're a witness. Just to be safe, though, I'd stay away from all public appearances. Especially the funeral.
You have the scum that murdered my daughter. And him nor 100 like him couldn't keep me from honoring her memory.
Hey.
Who are you?
I manage this place. Who the hell are you?
Draven. Eric. And you're Caleb.
What, are you some kind of joker?
You see something funny?
Eric Draven got thrown right through that window. They killed him. And his girlfriend. You may look like him, but you can't fool me. I'm going downstairs and calling the cops. You're out of here, mister.
Well, wait. I really am Draven. That whole window thing? It was just a scam.
What are you talking about?
I testified in a federal case. Major drug bust.
Damn musicians.
And they put Shelly and me in a witness protection program. They faked the whole murder thing to get us out of town.
So what are you doing back here?
I was homesick.
Look, you want this space? You pay the rent. $750 a month, first and last up front. You can tell those feds that they owe me for damages to this place. Since that happened, I can't rent the whole floor.
Ballistics reports are back from the lab. Bullets from Franklin Elise match Hedge's gun.
Big shock there.
I still wonder about motive.
Okay. Come on, Franklin fired the guy, then he refused to let him marry his daughter. That's not enough for you?
Except it turns out, Hedges wasn't fired. Our man found structural defects at the Seattle Hotel. Tried to get Franklin to shut down and do the repairs. Things got heated. Hedges threatened to go public. He was bought out. And for what he got, they could fire me any day.
Really? Because, you know, that could be arranged.
Uh-huh. Maybe you could arrange to fix the candy machine. Right.
Just gotta know where to hit it, so...
How did you get in here?
That old...
You know what? It doesn't matter. Come here. Quick, you first... Just go.
Sit down. Okay. So I'm sure you got a good reason to risk coming here.
It's about my loft. Landlord came in today and told me I have to pay rent or get out.
So move out. Place is trashed anyway.
I can't. Something incredible happened there last night.
Something you think is incredible?
This I gotta hear.
I saw Shelley. I talked to her. She's someplace else where I could actually see her. Now that loft is the only link I have to Shelley.
Draven, I'm too busy with the Hedges case in this life to explore the afterlife right now.
I don't know who else to talk to.
You need a wider circle of friends.
No, I need that loft.
So pay the man.
How?
The same way everyone else does. Get a job. Quit playing whatever game it is you're playing and get a life. That's my first and last contribution. The rest is on you.
Hedges held this.
How do you know that?
I just felt it. Shelley tried to tell me about this. Albrecht, this man did not do what everybody thinks he did.
Look, whether he did or not, he's been taken downtown in 10 minutes. Come on. You gotta go.
I'm right about this. You know I am.
So if he gets acquitted, you'll get a gold star.
And if he doesn't?
And if he doesn't, he's gonna go down for murder and attempted murder on Franklin. They're asked for the death penalty, and you know what? They'll probably get it.
You can live with that?
I don't have a choice. That's the system, friend. Come on. You gotta pay the rent. And play by the rules.
Well, they're not my rules. Thanks for the gesture.
Murder, we now have a special report.
We are live outside the Pacific Park Division, where just minutes from now, accused killer Gilbert Hedges will be moved prior to his arraignment. Hedges will be charged with the fatal shooting of his girlfriend, Elise Franklin, and the wounding of her father, John Franklin. At this point in time, police are not giving us any more detail, but we...
Do you know something? We may not have much, but in some ways, we got a lot more than the Franklins do.
Yeah, more debt.
I'm serious, kiddo. The family's cursed.
Hey, give me $100 million, I'll hire a good exorcist.
Do you think money solves everything?
It doesn't hurt.
Do you know that when Elise Franklin was a little girl, 3 or 4 years old, she was playing with matches and she burned down her daddy's office building? A lot of people died in that fire. Yeah, it was all over the news. And now this, you know, 28 years old, and poof, she's gone.
Maybe.
What do you mean, maybe? She's dead, Sarah.
Well, there's dead, and then there's dead.
Where do you get ideas like this?
Ann Button, I just meant it doesn't have to be the end of everything.
Okay, listen to me. There's nothing cool. Or romantic, or grown up about dying. It's an end. In this house, we're gonna focus on life, okay?
Okay.
Take it back streets, man.
Yeah, away from the damn news vans, huh?
You got that right.
Look out! What the hell? I didn't see him. Where the hell did he come from?
Look, go check on him. I'll call an ambulance. We got a man down here.
Copy that. What's your location?
Look, don't try to move.
I'm at McBride and 12th, right?
Right away, officer.
He's alive!
Not technically. No.
Hey! Hey! What are you doing?
You got the wrong man.
Back off or I'll shoot! What? Huh?
I don't have a problem with you. Let's keep it that way. Now you're just doing your job, so am I.
Who the hell are you?
I can explain it to you, or we can drive.
Drive.
Good choice.
Where are we now, boss man?
We're in a safe place.
Safe for who?
Hey! Hey! Listen to me! I'm not gonna hurt you. I am trying to help you.
Just take it easy, okay, man? I didn't kill her, all right?
Yeah, I know that. Why do you think I got you out
here? I don't know! I thought maybe you're a friend of Elise's. Maybe you work for her father. I figured somebody didn't want to wait for a trial.
Somebody may want you dead, but it's not me. I'm trying to help.
Why do you want to help me?
You wouldn't understand.
Try me.
Let's just leave it at you didn't do it. I'm trying to help.
Who's in there?
Are you better off than you were 2 hours ago?
Yeah.
Shut up and let me help.
Eric, what are you doing in there?
I was just on my way to your office.
Is there someone with you? I thought I heard voices.
Oh, I was just talking to myself, an old habit of mine.
Eric, what were you doing in there that you don't want to talk about?
I'm sorry. I needed a place to crash. I knew you didn't use the storeroom.
Well, if anyone owes you a favor, I guess I do. I thought you had a place.
Well, I do, but suddenly I have a landlord demanding rent.
So what you really need is money?
Yeah, I guess.
I have an idea. I could really do with someone who's been on the performance side of things. Plus, I've seen you're a pretty tough guy. Work with me. I'll pay you.
A lot of people don't know what to make of me since I came back.
Good. Then they won't cause any trouble.
Thanks.
We've just lost the highest profile criminal in the last 20 years. Look like the damn Keystone Cops here. Al, you give them the ugly details. I'm too disgusted to even read this thing again.
Here. All right. Transport crew claims that a guy came from out of nowhere, stepped in front of the truck, got pasted to the pavement, and ran right over him. They went to render aid. The man got up and disarmed them. That's what we're dealing with.
You got a description?
Yeah, mid to late 20s, long black hair, Asian or Hispanic. His face was painted with some kind of war paint. Hell of a fighter, too, apparently. They shot him, and he kept on coming. Van was driven 6 blocks and abandoned. We're sweeping the area.
I want this guy found. And we're not waiting for the uniforms to do it.
That's it.
I was trying to get out of here.
And where would you go?
I was gonna call you when I got there. Well, that woman obviously didn't buy your act out there, huh? You know, I think I'd be better off walking on the street with a clown nose and funny glasses on. What do you think?
But it's enough time to do what needs to be done.
And what is that?
You ask too many questions.
I haven't even started asking questions yet. Like, first of all, who are you, huh?
What's the deal with your monster movie looking? Why don't you look like that now?
All right. I'm Eric Draven. I was murdered. I came back. I don't understand how or why any better than you do. When I need to, I turn into what you saw. I believe I'm supposed to set things right in this world, or at least try. Any more questions?
Yeah, what do we do now?
I have an idea, but we'll wait until dark. All right?
All right.
Please!
Yeah, well, I guess we're crazy enough to bring him here. Ah. This is a secret to the damn universe. Huh? Well, we got problems.
Mr. Davies, I doubt you've heard about that killer Hedges.
Everybody in the city's talking about it.
Well, I'm not interested in water cooler chatter. I want to know what happened.
I put a call in to our inside man. He said somebody hit the transport van and broke him out.
You mean he had help? Somebody on the inside, a professional? Does Gil have connections?
We don't know. They're keeping a real tight lid on it.
Well, you tell our man that he'd better find a way to pry that lid open. His career curve is riding on it. And double our security here at the hotel. Get outside help if you have to.
Yes, of course. But you don't think he'd really try and come back here again?
Never underestimate a desperate man.
Hey, I need to talk to you. Is there somewhere we can talk?
Okay, over here. Detective!
I'm looking for Draven.
I've told you before, he only comes here sometimes. I don't know what he does or where he goes.
Have you seen him today?
Has he done something?
Maybe. Have you seen him or not?
Eric Draven is a good man, I know it. Afternoon.
That'd be sometime after 2:45?
Yes.
He didn't by any chance tell you where he was going, huh?
No.
Yeah, I didn't think so.
And the wounding of her father, John Franklin. At this point in time, police are giving us...
Where you at?
I'm in here.
We'll keep you informed as the case unfolds.
You looking at?
You're late.
Oh, long day. You don't want to know.
Oh, I do.
I had a tip that Gil Hedges was hiding out in King Henry.
Was he?
Well, if he was, I couldn't find him.
News says you guys aren't talking about the way Hedges escaped.
And we're not. You know the rule about pillow talk.
You're no fun. Well, at least you had your man for a while. You get him back.
Yeah. Well, assuming he's our man.
You think he's not?
Well, Hedges says that Elise told him somebody had it in for the old man. Oh,
Daryl, baby, sometimes the obvious answer is the right one. Franklin stopped him from marrying the daughter, and boom.
No, not in front of a room full of people. Not with his own gun. Hedges is smarter than that.
Smart people do dumb things, especially when they're emotionally disturbed.
Oh, well... The one who was emotionally disturbed was Elise. Oh, yeah, not Hedges. One was in therapy forever.
He probably put her there. Talk to her shrink.
Can't, it's protected.
Well, the patient's dead.
Ping. You know, you're far too smart to be my girlfriend.
So they tell me.
What? Come here. Come here. Give me the headlock.
Saying we can't talk to Elise, she's dead.
And you're well on your way to joining her if we don't find out who the real killer is.
This will certainly help with my insanity defense, won't it?
Mallet now.
You concentrate. Clear your mind of everything else. Think of Elise.
I think about her all the time. It doesn't help.
Did you love her?
What?
Did you love her?
Yeah. I loved every part of her. I loved her so much that right now I'd rather be dead so I wouldn't have to feel this pain anymore.
It's not that simple. Something's happening, you feel it?
Yeah, I think so, yeah.
What is it? I don't know. All of a sudden, I can feel it's Gil. He needs me.
With him. Help me show him what he needs to know.
How?
You told me you saw the whole thing. Just remember what you saw.
My entire personal fortune will be used to establish and maintain a network of cutting edge.
What?
Let go of me! This is a mistake, okay? You've got to shoot him!
What is it?
The men who tackled you. They did it.
Franklin's men killed Elise.
Well, look who's returned to the scene of the crime.
Looks like we found ourselves an assassin.
Get up, punk.
Maybe we ought to make a citizen's arrest here.
You've got the right to remain silent.
Back off!
I don't know what you're doing here with him. That makes you an eyewitness. That's bad news.
Let's call the boss.
Dr. Sidney Lizelle. Name ring a bell?
Yeah, sure. Big time shrink, died in a carjacking a couple weeks ago. I've read the report. What about him?
He was Elise Franklin's psychiatrist, is what? And I bet you we'll find a missing file in his office under F.
So, Gil, we finally get to conclude our business.
You are a bastard. You get your subhuman cronies to murder Elise, and then you pin it on me.
Gil, I may have underestimated you, but nobody's gonna believe that story. Especially now, with you running like a scared and guilty man. What I would like to know is who broke you out.
Sleeping Beauty over there, huh? Right, he's been out for 3 hours. He can't even get up off the floor.
Yeah, well, when he wakes up, you boys are gonna be surprised.
Oh, this'll all be over by then, Gil. You're gonna have to face it. Nobody's gonna rescue you this time.
It's not gonna work. So you kill me, they're just gonna charge you for murder anyway.
Well, not if it's self-defense, Mr. Davies. You tried to kill me at the Better Future meeting. Then you broke out and came back here to finish the job, but your gun jammed.
Don't get any ideas. It's not loaded. Not right now, anyway.
You better go make it look like there was a break-in, and then call the police.
How could you do this?
You really are clueless, aren't you?
Better than being hopeless.
And who are you supposed to be?
Room service?
Go! Go!
Man,
Better hurry up, Mr. Bodyguard.
3 points!
I'm there. They got Hedges at the Franklin Hotel.
You could kill again, Franklin.
But it won't bury what you did to your daughter.
Well, I haven't done anything. I'm just a grieving parent.
Missed me. People know you had her killed.
Everyone who did is either dead or will be.
Look at that. Missed again.
All right, Kabuki Man, what now?
From high atop the luxurious Franklin Hotel, you confess to your crimes.
Bullseye got me that time.
Oops.
Oh, no, please!
Craven! Craven, don't do this! Pull him back, now!
Ask him about Elise. What did she know?
Why was your daughter in pain?
She was having nightmares. The fire in my office.
Elise, how many times have I told you not to play with magic?
You were her nightmare.
No.
You started that fire.
No. It was an accident.
You lie, you die.
Franklin, take him back now!
She went to that damn shrink and made her remember everything. She made me give it all away. She made me sign away all my money.
You had your daughter murdered for money?
Don't do this.
You said things right. As right as they can be. Thank you.
Didn't know you were a rock and roll fan.
Well, you know, Jimmy Reed, John Lee Hooker's more my thing. So you took my advice, get yourself a job.
Something like that.
Gil Hedges is free. Franklin's up on murder charges. He signed a confession. You were right.
Mighty big of you to come all the way out here and tell me that.
I didn't. Here's what I decided about you. One, you're probably Eric Draven. I ran the prints off the glass you touched. Two, no matter who you are, you're as sick of what's going on out there in the streets as I am. Three, you got some things going on that I cannot explain. The only way I can tolerate you operating out there without a badge is if I know what you're doing. I don't care if you call, write a note, or send up a damn bat signal.
And if I don't agree?
Then I'm gonna have to take you down, even if it means me going down with you. No job, no loft, no window, or whatever it is you call it.
I don't take orders from you.
I don't clean up your mess.
I can change my mind at any time.
So can I.
Deal.
Deal. Later.
Hey, Albrecht, I can get you in for free. It's a good show. Gonna miss it.
You're ready to move on.
I think I need to. Staying here is all about what my father did. Do you think Gil would understand that?
I'm sure he would. When his time comes, he'll find you.
Come with me.
I can't.
You're gonna wait for him.
For as long as it takes.
This Grove Stairway to Heaven included music from Crystal Meth, Wild Strawberries,